What's up, guys? Welcome back to my YouTube channel where I help eczema warriors get rid of inflammation, itch, and the uncomfortable skin. So in today's video, we're going to be talking about four foods you should be eating for healthy skin. In the previous video here, I talked about foods you should be avoiding if you have eczema. So if you want to learn more about what you can eat instead, then be sure to continue watching this video. So the very first food you should be eating if you have eczema are sea vegetables. So plants that are found in the sea actually have a lot of nutrients, including protein, minerals, vitamins. For example, some sea vegetables include Atlantic dulse, nori, and kelp. So one way you can actually start including these sea vegetables in your diet is to either have them as a snack, which sometimes it might not work for everyone because it does taste a little bit salty. But how I like to include sea vegetables in my diet for my skin is to actually blend it in a smoothie. So in the morning for my breakfast, I like to add a handful of Atlantic dulse and just blend it up in there. And that's a really good way to get your nutrients in. Now, sea vegetables are particularly important for those who have eczema because they are natural detoxifiers. And as someone who has eczema, you likely have some kind of toxic load in your body, which is why you have so much inflammation. So when you have natural detoxifiers like sea vegetables in your diet, that is one way to help with removing toxic burden. You might be wondering where to buy sea vegetables. And I'm not talking about the packaged seaweed that you get at the Asian supermarket. I mean, those could be great, but a lot of them have chemicals and additives added in them. The ones that you really want to get are the ones that you find at a natural health food store. So typically these supplement stores that sell vitamins and minerals, and if they have a grocery section, then you're able to find things like Atlantic dulse, kelp, and wakame is another one. Now the next food you guys should be including for your eczema is flax oil. So, or flax seeds. Flax seeds and flax oil are really great for eczema because they are high in omega-3s. And omega-3s have been shown to reduce inflammation. Now, I like to use flax oil because I can actually add that into my smoothie. So this one that I use, I add about 2 tablespoons of it into my smoothie every morning. Now, you wanna be careful with what kind of flax oil you're getting. You wanna make sure that you're choosing organic and unrefined. This one that I have, you actually don't cook it. You can't heat it. So the only way to really use it is to put it in a smoothie, or you can drizzle it on oatmeal, for example. So yeah, flaxseed and flax oil is great for eczema. Try to add enough into your smoothie. So I usually put 1 to 2 tablespoons every day. And the reason why I recommend flax oil or flaxseed is if you were to get the flaxseed version, not only is it high in omega-3s, it also contains fiber, right? So we need fiber if we want to heal our skin. So you get 2 benefits, right? You get the fiber and you also get the omega-3s. So if you're choosing the flaxseed version, you always want to get the ground flaxseed, okay? The whole flaxseed, if you don't blend it, you're actually not able to digest whole flaxseed. So you got to make sure you guys are getting the ground version. So the next food you should eat for your eczema are Brazil nuts. So Brazil nuts are very, very high in selenium, and one Brazil nut actually can give you 70 to 90 micrograms of selenium. Now, why is selenium so important? Selenium is an important mineral for skin healing. In addition to that, it is actually a component of antioxidant called glutathione. And glutathione is something that your liver needs in order to have its detox pathway work well. So if you're not eating enough selenium or you don't have enough in your body, then you might have lower levels of glutathione. And so Brazil nuts is a really great way to get enough of that in your diet. Now, of course, as always, if you're someone who is allergic to nuts, then definitely don't eat Brazil nuts. But these are just people who don't have any sensitivities to nuts. So the next food you guys should include in your diet for eczema are blueberries. Now, I talk a lot about blueberries, I feel like, on my Instagram, in my posts, and that's because blueberries are basically like the highest antioxidant food on earth, in my opinion. They are high in nutrients, high in fiber, and they contain a pigment called anthocyanin, which is what gives blueberries that blue and purple color. Anthocyanins not only help with reducing inflammation, but it also helps to fight off free radicals, okay? So free radicals are something that your body produces all the time. Also, when you're exposed to toxins in the air and pesticides and whatnot, so that's how free radicals are produced. Now, the way to combat these free radicals so they don't damage your cells and your body is to include higher antioxidant foods. So blueberries is one of them. Just to show you guys what I use in my smoothie is I have a organic wild blueberry. It's frozen blueberries that I get from Costco. And I like to grab like a couple bags of them just to keep them in my freezer. And yeah, I blend my blueberries in my smoothie. It's a great way, like I said, to get your nutrients in, especially right now in the winter time. You can't really get blueberries in season, right? So one way to make sure you can still get blueberries is to buy them in the frozen version. All right, now at this point in the video, you learned 4 foods you should be including in your diet for your eczema. All right, so the next food you should be eating for your eczema are sweet potatoes. Now, sweet potatoes are high in beta carotene, which converts to vitamin A. In a previous post that I made on my Instagram right here, I talked about certain nutrients and vitamins you need for your skin, and vitamin A is one of them. Now, vitamin A helps to increase skin hydration, promote collagen synthesis, and also helps with skin repair. That's why I recommend sweet potatoes, because it provides those nutrients. Now, a way you can include sweet potatoes in your diet is to either steam them, or you can roast them, or you can even actually blend them in a smoothie. I know that sounds a little bit weird, but you can actually steam the sweet potato till it's soft and then make a sweet potato smoothie. Sweet potatoes are also high in fiber, and like I mentioned previously, fiber is really important when it comes to healing your eczema because it helps to promote bowel movements, but also helps to feed healthy gut bacteria. We need healthy gut bacteria if you want to heal your skin. Now, as always, be sure to check out my Instagram if you want to learn a little bit more about how you can manage your eczema. And also check out my 2 videos right here where I share lots of nutrition tips for eczema. Thanks, guys, and I'll see you guys in the next video.